Module 6, Section 10.2, The Law of Cosines. Given side angle side or side side side, we form a unique triangle. There is a triangle side restriction, however. In any triangle, the sum of the lengths of any two sides must be greater than the length of the remaining side, or no triangle is formed, as we see here. Here we have the law of cosines. In any triangle ABC with sides A, B, and C, to find the side, one of the sides, squared, we take the other two sides squared and sum them, minus 2 times those two sides times the cosine of our angle, which is opposite the side we're trying to find. And you'll notice that's true for each of the three definitions here. Here we'll use the law of cosines to solve a triangle given side angle side. Here we have angle A is 42.3 degrees, side B is 12.9 meters, and side C is 15.4 meters. So the first thing we'll do is find side A using the law of cosines. We know that A squared will be equal to B squared plus C squared minus 2BC cosine of angle A. So we'll end up with A squared is equal to 12.9 squared plus 15.4 squared minus 2 times 12.9 times 15.4 times the cosine of 42.3 degrees. So we pull up our calculator, making sure we're in degree mode, and we are. We'll punch this in, 12.9 squared plus 15.4 squared minus 2 times 12.9 times 15.4 times the cosine of 42.3. And we see that we get about 109.7. So then we want to take the square root of our answer, and we get approximately 10.47. So we had that A squared was 109.7, and we took the square root of both sides and got an answer for A of about 10.47 meters. Now that we know side A, we can use the law of sines to find our angle B. So we know that the sine of A over A is equal to the sine of B over B. So we have that the sine of 42.3 over 10.47 is equal to the sine of B over 12.9. So here we'll multiply both sides by 12.9, and we'll end up with the sine of B is equal to the sine of 42.3 times 12.9 divided by 10.47. So let's open up our calculator. And we have the sine of 42.3 times 12.9 divided by 10.47. So we have that the sine of B is approximately 0.83. And to find what B is, then, we take the inverse sine of our answer here, and we'll get a value of B of approximately 56 degrees. Now that we know angles A and B, we can find angle C by taking 180 degrees minus the other two angles. And when we work this out, we'll get a value for C of 81 0.7 degrees. So here we've solved our triangle. Now let's use the law of cosines to solve a triangle given side, side, side. Here we have side A is 9.47 feet, side B is 15.9 feet, and side C is 21.1 feet. So what we'll do is we'll use the first value for law of cosines, and what we're going to do is we're going to solve this for the cosine of A. So we'll subtract b squared and subtract c squared from both sides. And then we'll divide both sides by negative 2bc. So we end up with the cosine of A is equal to a squared minus b squared minus c squared divided by negative 2bc. So we'll plug in our values. We have 9.47 squared minus 15.9 squared minus 21.1 squared divided by negative 2 times 15.9 times 21.1. So let's plug this into our calculator and evaluate. And we want to divide by negative 2 times 15.9 times 21.1. Now remember, this is the value of the cosine of A, so to find A, we'll take the inverse cosine of our answer, and we get a value for A of about 24.95. Degrees. Now to find angle B, we'll use the law of sines, and we know that the sine of B over B is equal to the sine of A over A. And we'll multiply both sides here by whatever B is. So we have that the sine of B is equal to the sine of 24.95 degrees divided by 9.47 and then multiplied by 15.9. So we have sine of 24.95 divided by 9.47 and then multiplied by 15.9. So we get that the sine of B is equal to about 0.708, and we'll take the inverse sine of our answer to get a value for B of about 45.09 degrees. Now to find angle C, we're going to take 180 degrees minus our two angles we just found. And we'll get a value of about 109.96 degrees for angle C. Here we have a summary of the possible cases we can encounter with suggested procedures to follow. Case 1 was described, and we did an example, in section 10.1, where we use the law of sines. Case 2 is our ambiguous case, and we won't be looking at it in this course. Case 3 was the first example we did in this video, side angle side. We find the third side using the law of cosines, find the smaller of the two remaining angles using the law of sines, and then find the remaining angle using the angle sum formula. And then case 4 was the example, the last example we just did, side, side, side. And we see that the procedure is about the same as the one above. Looking at area formulas, the law of cosines can be used to derive a formula for the area of a triangle given the lengths of three sides, known as Heron's formula. In Heron's formula, if a triangle has sides of lengths A, B, and C, and if the semiperimeter given by S equals 1/2 the sum of all of our sides, then the area of the triangle is area equals the square root of our semiperimeter multiplied by the semiperimeter minus each of the sides. So let's do an example. We want to use Heron's formula to find an area. The distance as the crow flies from Los Angeles to New York is 2,451 miles. From New York to Montreal is 331 miles. And from Montreal to Los Angeles is 2,427 miles. What is the area of the triangular region having these three cities as vertices, ignoring the curvature of the Earth? So if we ignore curvature, then we have a flat triangle as so. And in order to use Heron's formula, the first thing we need to do is to find the semiperimeter. So S is equal to 1/2 the sum of all of our sides. So we have 2,451 plus 331 plus 2,427. When we work this out, we'll get a value of our semiperimeter of about 2604.5. Now that we know that, we can plug into our area equation the square root of 2604.5 times that value minus A times that value again minus B times that value again minus C. So when we work this out in our calculator, we'll see that we get an area of 401,664.1109, or approximately 401,664. The area of any triangle is given by area equals 1/2 base times height, where B is its base and H is its height, as we see in the picture below. In this picture also, the sine of A is H over C, the opposite over the hypotenuse. And we can solve this for H, and we get an equation, H equals C times the sine of A. So if we plug that in, we see that we then have the area formula, 1/2 base times height, is equal to 1/2 BC sine of A. So that leads to the following formulas for the area of a triangle. We see that formula as well as what happens with the other sides and angles involved. In this example, we want to find the area of a triangle given side, angle, side. You see that we have side C, and we have side A, and angle B. So our area formula will be 1/2 AC times the sine of B. So we have 1/2 times 34 times 42 times the sine of 55 degrees . We plug this into our calculator, and we get 1/2 times 34 times 42 times the sine of 55, and we see that we get a value of about 584.87 for our area.